You know, karaoke is honestly one of the reasons why I feel like I'm a singer, was because all those Filipino parties where there's tons of lumpia and there's tons of karaoke singing Mariah Carey and Whitney Houston songs, that's number one. Old, so it feels crazy. I feel so blessed and so thankful. And I was very surprised. I didn't expect all of these amazing things to happen. And I knew, you know, that certain things would happen, but it just felt like, wow, you know, you never really can be prepared for that feeling. So I'm really thankful. Most Filipino things I do, my mom calling me to cook the rice before, you know, she gets home and teaching me the finger trick, you know, in the rice. That's the number one thing. And, you know, taking off my shoes at the front door. And my father, you know, my grandparents used to live in the house with us, which I know, you know, is a lot of Filipinos. Their grandparents live in the house. And my dad used to send me to my grandparents' bedroom to translate and tell him what they're talking about, to see if they're talking about him. And of course, my tita Joanne, who I make fun of all the time because she's super, super Filipino and super hilarious.
My tita Joanne would say, "Oh my God, I am so proud of you. You have Grammys, wow. Diamond, is that diamond?"
Sharon Canetta, I used to sing Maging Sino Kaman all the time at all the family parties. They would say, "Sing, come on, sing Maging Sino Kaman. Come on, anak, sing it." They used to tell me that at every single party. Like, there are so many different messages. I'm even discovering the messages within my music. I think number one is, you know, that being comfortable with being vulnerable. And I always say this, I say the things that sit in the back of people's minds, in the back of my mind. And that's the name of my album, just because I think my message has always been, you know, the music is important and being comfortable with yourself, the evolution of women, but also going against the grain and being who you are unapologetically. I always think that's the message. You know, I don't think it was much of like hiding my identity, but really just making the music the forefront. I think a lot of times we listen with our eyes and not our ears. And I think with social media, everybody wants to be a star. You know, everybody is the face of everything. Everybody wants to their personality to show. And I really wanted people to focus on the music and focus on my message. You know, just as an artist, I felt like that was the most important thing, the substance, the writing, the songwriting, the authenticity. So that was really important to me. I first of all, you know, maraming salamat, because that means the world to me, you know, to know that part of my heritage is always supporting me in everything that I do. And yeah, you know, I want to continue to put out music and hopefully come to the Philippines and do a show so I can be connected and meet you all in person. That's really what I'm looking forward to, is coming back to the Philippines.